Hello to all my dear student. How are you? I am Dipen Singh, your biology teacher. Welcome to all of you in our school SJEC e-learning YouTube channel. So student, as you know, we are discussing second unit, genetic and evolutions, fifth chapter, principle of inheritance and variation. And we already discussed various topic and concepts about the principle of inheritance in our previous classes. In our last class, we just discussed about variation. So first question is, what is variation? Variations are morphological, physiological, cytological and behavioral differences among individual of a species and also the offspring of the same parent. Means variation are the rule of nature and no two individuals are identical. Even identical twins, when placed in different environment, they show differences. And on the basis of morphological, cytological, physiological and behavioral differences, we differentiate variation into two categories: non-heritable variations and heritable variation, in which heritable variation are also divided into two types: continuous variation and discontinuous variation, which we already discussed in our last videos. So we start today's class with discontinuous variation. First of all, discontinuous variation are the differences in a characteristic that can be observed in a population. Characteristics that are determined by different alleles at a single locus show discontinuous variation. The examples are garden pea are either wrinkled or smooth, and on the basis of this we also can divide the discontinuous variation into following three types. First of all, gene mutation, means the changes in the structure of gene. Second type is chromosomal aberration, means changes in the structure of chromosome. And at last, genomic mutation, means the changes in the number of chromosomes. Clear? Let's see what is gene mutation, means the changes in the structure of genes. First of all, gene mutations are changes in the fine structure of genes. Since genes are DNA segments, the gene mutation include changes in the number or arrangement of nucleotide in the genes. Means these are known as intragenic mutation. Then the gene mutation are sudden stable changes in DNA structure. These are also known as intragenic because there are the changement of genes located on a different species. Though these involve very minor changes in DNA but may modify the information conveyed by them and have far-reaching consequences for the organism. Is for example, a change of a single nitrogenous base in the gene that codes for beta chain of hemoglobin causes sickle cell anemia. Means lethal genes, albino characters, and chlorophyll deficiencies are also caused by the gene mutation. Now, what are the causes and types of gene mutation? The change in the sequence of nitrogenous base may be due to the following two types of changes, or we can say that the gene mutation may be following two types: frame shift mutation, which is also known as replacement of a base pair, nucleotide base pair, in the DNA segment. Changes in the number of nucleotide in a DNA segment. And the second one is the substitution mutation, means the cistron or DNA segment replace or change by the nucleotide pair. Let's see what is frame shift mutation. First of all, it is the changes in the number of nucleotide in a DNA segment cistron, and these changes are caused by deletion or addition, insertion of one or more nucleotide in a DNA segment. As we know, since genetic code is commonless, both addition as well as deletion of nucleotide shift the reading frame of codon from the site of change onward. Therefore, these mutations are known as frame shift mutation, as we can also see in the given diagram. Means these mutation changes the sequence of amino acid in a protein, means the different from the normal one. The change is from the point of deletion or insertion, and the new polypeptide chain may be entirely different from the normal one, and it may be modified, deleterious or inactive. For example, in human being, the hereditary diseases muscular dystrophy is caused by frame shift mutation, which leads to premature termination of translation of protein dystrophin. Okay, our second type is the substitution mutation, means the replacement of a base pair, means nucleotide pair found in a DNA segment or cistron. These are caused either by transition or transversion. Let's see what happened in transition and transversion. First of all, in transition, a purine is replaced by another purine and a pyrimidine is replaced by another pyrimidine, such as given in the diagram. Clear? Next type of substitution mutation is transversion, means in a transversion, a purine replaced by a pyrimidine or a pyrimidine replaced by a purine, as shown in the diagram. Means the substitution mutation alters a single codon, which replaces amino acid, a single amino acid in a polypeptide chain. And even this could change nature of the protein and the character associated with it. The gene mutations occurring due to change in a single nucleotide are called point mutation. And gene mutation which involve change of more than one nucleotide are called gross mutation. Means most mutations occur due to errors in DNA replication or transcription. Therefore, they are called copy error mutation. And they may be nonsense, missense and same sense mutation. Such as in the case of nonsense mutation, the mutation produce the terminator codon with the coded message, and therefore the synthesis of polypeptide chain is interrupted and the gene between codons become non-functional or recessive, and these terminator codon may be UGA, UUA, UAA in mRNA. Clear? Okay, let's see the next type of discontinuous variation is chromosomal aberration. Means the chromosomal mutation involve modification in the morphology of or structure of chromosome and are usually described as chromosomal aberrations. These may be intrachromosomal, wherein changes occur in the number or arrangement of genes within a single chromosome, such as deficiency and inversion, and interchromosomal, which occur due to equal or unequal exchange of parts between homologous or non-homologous chromosome, means duplication and translation. Let's see what is deficiency or deletion type of changes in the structure of chromosome. The type deletion is related with intrachromosomal modification. Means the changes occur in the number of arrangement of genes within a single chromosome. Here is a diagram which represents the deficiency or deletion. And we can easily see that it involves the loss of one or more gene due to loss of a part of chromosome. The chromosome become shorter and the deletion may be terminal or intercalary. Deletion can be identified at the time of synapses of homologous chromosome during meiosis. Means here is a chromosome represented by genes A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H and I, and in this the segment D, E, F is deleted or lost, then the new chromosome become short, which is A, B, C, G, H, I, due to the deletion or deficiency or of D, E, F. This is the intrachromosomal modification, means the changes occur in the number of arrangement. Let's see the inversion, which is also the type of intrachromosomal modification. Inversion. It involves the rotation of a block of gene within a chromosome at 180 degree. For example, if the original chromosome is A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I base pair, it may change to A, B, C, F, E, D, G, H, I due to the Inversion means, it means inversion include break of a chromosome into two or more segment, and one of which may rejoin in an inverted position. And inversion may be terminal or intercalary. As we can easily see in this diagram, the segment DEF inverted into FED and forms a new chromosome with gene base pair ABC FED GHI. Clear? Our next topic is interchromosomal modification related with chromosomal aberration. And in this, the changes occur due to equal or unequal exchange of parts between homologous or non-homologous chromosome. It is also divided into two types, duplication or repeat and translocation. Let's see both. First, duplication. It involves the addition of one or more genes due to the fusion of an additional segment from homologous chromosome. Therefore, in duplication, some genes are present twice. Means duplication may occur either by unequal crossing over between homologous chromosome or by the fusion of an additional segment from one homologous to the other. As we can see in the diagram, the first chromosome in which base pairs are A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I. Then a duplicated segment again added in this chromosome. The new base pair in newly formed chromosome are A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, which represent the original and normal one, while the F, G, H, I added is a duplicate segment. Clear? This is form an extra length of chromosome is added on. Next type is translocation. In translocation, a segment of a chromosome breaks off and joins a non-homologous chromosome, forming a new linkage group. Means in this case, the donor chromosome suffers deletion and the recipient chromosome has an extra set of genes from some other linkage group. Translocation may be reciprocal or non-reciprocal. Means it is also divided in two type of condition, reciprocal or non-reciprocal. Let's see. Reciprocal translocation means it involves exchange of parts between two non-homologous chromosomes to form new reciprocal or mutual chromosome with new linkage groups. For example, the original chromosome is A, B, C, D, E, F and W, X, Y, Z. Exchange their parts to form new chromosome. Parts means genes with gene arrangement A, B, C, Y, Z and W, X, D, E, F. This is a reciprocal translocation. And in the diagram shown, the non-reciprocal translocation means it involves transfer of part of a chromosome to some non-homologous chromosome. For example, transfer of chromosome segment DEF from ABC DEF chromosome to WXYZ chromosome. This results in two new chromosomes, one with ABC genes and the other with DEF WXYZ genes. Clear? Good. Now the what is the significance of effect of chromosomal aberration? Means the structural changes in chromosomes occur due to error during meiotic division and result in changed number of genes or changed sequences of genes in the chromosome. The genes in a new or changed location may be produced, change some phenotypic expression, or may prove to be lethal, causing the death of the individual. And the inversion and translocation interfere with the normal chromosomal pairing during meiosis and reduce chances of crossing over and also the formation of gametes. Okay, students. Our next and last discontinuous variation is genomic mutation. Let's see what happened in this type of mutation. First of all, the numerical changes in chromosome number occurred in this type of mutation and may be following two types, euploidy and aneuploidy. First, see what is euploidy and what happened in the condition of euploidy. It includes addition or loss of a complete one set or more than one set of chromosome in diploid organism. And in euploidy, there is also duplication of same haploid set, means the genome of that particular organism, means it is also divided and it may be also divided into following types. First of all, monoploidy, which is also known as haploidy, and it involve loss of a complete one set of chromosome from a diploid organism, so that the resulting offspring have just one set of chromosome. While in the case of polyploidy, it involve addition of one or more sets of chromosome in a diploid organism, so that each chromosome is represented by more than two homologous chromosome. And it is also divided into different types on the basis of set of chromosomes, such as triploid, which include three set of chromosome, tetraploid include four set of chromosome, pentaploid include five set of chromosome. Clear? Now the importance of polyploidy, means what is the importance of polyploidy? First of all, it represent the varieties and species of various crops such as rice, gram and maize, and have arisen by the autopolyploidy and American cotton, Nicotina tabacum, and wheat have arisen by the allopolyploidy. Clear? Okay. Next type of chromosomal aberration is aneuploidy. And in aneuploidy, there is a loss or addition of one or more chromosomes to a haploid genome. Means the loss of one or more chromosome from the genome represent hypopolyploidy. And addition of one or more chromosome to the genome is called hyperpolyploidy. Means their chromosome number is not in exact multiple of its haploid chromosome number, and such organisms are called aneuploids or heteroploids. And aneuploids are arise due to failure of the separation of the homologous chromosome of a particular pair during the process of meiosis. And the gametes either have a particular chromosome missing or in excess. And these abnormality or abnormal gamete on the fertilization produce aneuploids. and they can also be divided into following types. Monosomic means these aneuploid lack both the chromosome of a particular pair from the diploid genome. These are represented by 2N-2 and they arise by the fusion of N-1 and N-1 type of gamete. Okay. And next type is nullisomy. Then polysomic, mixed aneuploid, there are various differentiation. But the question is, what is the significance of aneuploidy? First of all, the aneuploidy provide information about the phenotypic effect of those genes which are in trisomic state or in monosomic state. And it help in determining location of genes on chromosomes. Means in human being, aneuploid show a variety of syndrome such as Klinefelter syndrome, Turner syndrome, Down syndrome and Patu syndrome. These type of syndromic disease also known as human genetic disorders. Clear? And in plant, aneuploidy has resulted in the origin of new varieties of fruits and cereals. Means there are various effects of aneuploidy on plant and animal both. So student, here we completed our concept about variation. The types of variation, their subtypes, and also the different types of chromosomal changes, gene changes, inversion, deletion, deficiency, and aploidy and aneuploidy. Clear? So student, thanks for watching our video, and if you like our way of teaching and hard work, so please subscribe our channel to learn more and be updated about your syllabus.